everyone, and welcome back to another speed build on my channel. Today we are building a starter home for one sim located in Windenburg. I will be using a random build generator today because, truth be told, I've been having a little bit of a creative block, so I needed somewhere as a starting point. Shortly you will see the prompts coming up on the top left hand corner of the screen, but basically what I tried to do was to mimic sort of the general feel of Windenburg, which I've noticed is very simple builds and minimal to no landscaping. And as you can see in the prompts above, it says that I'm to build a pink mansion in Windenburg with the lot trait homie for one sim with a budget of 63k, but I decided to make it a starter home, so that's what we're working with. It must also include a cupcake machine, yoga room, and a fishbowl or aquarium. So I've laid out these items on the front yard for now so I don't have to waste my time scrolling through the catalog for them later on. And as you can see right now, I am stylizing the outside of the house. This house I kind of freeformed, which is something I don't really do because I usually like to follow a floor plan, but I think it turned out pretty well, if I might say so myself. And I tried to put in this wallpaper on the exterior that kind of looked like the patterns on most of the Windenburg houses, but unfortunately that wallpaper doesn't have a pink swatch, so I went with this half brick, half slat kind of look in the end, and I quite like how it turned out. This house is a one bed, one bath. It has a living room, the yoga room, and the kitchen on the first floor, and the bedroom and bathroom on the second floor. While my initial intention was to make the kitchen a very small, cozy, simple setup, I didn't realize I actually had to put that cupcake machine in the house somewhere. And obviously the kitchen made the most sense, so I had to slightly enlarged the kitchen by a little teensy bit, and so I'm placing the cupcake machine in one corner first again, and then the other half of the kitchen will probably be a very simple kitchen counter, fridge, stove setup, as you will see coming up real soon. I'm also adding the yoga mat and the meditation stool in the yoga room, and I do finish it a little bit more later on, but now I'm just deciding on the tiling and the wallpaper of the different rooms. I did not manage to add stairs in this build because of the limited space, but I had to make do with a ladder, and that goes up to the bedroom upstairs. And now we're finishing the living room. I tried to make this as simple as possible, minimalistic, but then I realized the sim would probably need some form of entertainment, so I did end up adding a television, which initially I added one of the cheap televisions on top of the fireplace, and then I realized, do people even do that? Is that a hazard? Is that a thing? If you live somewhere where fireplaces are a common thing, let me know if that's a thing or how people do it. I know they usually place it above the fireplace, but I don't know if anyone does like directly on the mantelpiece. So anyways, just a random thought I had during this building process. And I eventually decided not to put that end table there, and so the fishbowl went directly on top of the fireplace. And then I tried to create this breakfast nook situation. Later on you will see that, but right now I'm building the cooking portion of the kitchen, so I tried to make it as simple as possible with these base game counters, and then I used the pink stove and fridge for pop of color since the kitchen is mostly neutral. And coming up here, I'm trying to figure out how I'm going to place this cupcake machine so that it's functional and, you know, it makes sense in the space of the kitchen. By the way, this is playtested, so if you want to use it for gameplay, it is completely functional. And I'm also now trying to figure out, as you can see, the yoga room. Again, adding pops of color in the yoga mat and meditation stool. And here we are once again in the bathroom, where I simply don't have that much of like ideas, and it's very rare that I will decorate a bathroom very extravagantly. Usually, and especially in small builds, you know, as long as it has the basic necessities, we're good. So finally we're on to the bedroom, and this is probably the most pink part of the house. And I decided to give it a very pink, brown, and white color theme. So here I have a single bed for a single sim, and then a little nightstand with a lamp. Of course, they need a dresser as well, books, because again, skill building, and also this rug, which fit in so nicely, the color scheme. It's pink, but it's also not too obnoxious or too loud. I have a little mirror so they can practice their debate. They can, you know, do all those things to build up their charisma. And I'm just shifting things around a little bit so that it kind of makes more sense in terms of layout and the sim coming up, the letter and all that. And yeah, and I'm just refining the build by shifting around some things. And I think I swapped out the door because I finally ended up using a cheaper door here. Added a little bit of railing and the usual things like the mailbox and the garbage can. And yeah, that's about it, I think. And the screenshots will be coming up real soon, so stay around for that. And you can also view pictures over my Instagram at Vantastic07. That is also my gallery ID if you would like to download this build. And oh yes, I did switch out this little dining area a little bit, simplified it, and kind of shifted it around in front of the yoga room. But yeah, I think that is about it with this build. Finally, I'll add on a few more bits and bobs to the yoga room, and then we will move on to the screenshots. Once again, thank you so much for joining me in today's speed build. I hope you've enjoyed it, and if you'd like to see more builds like this, click on the playlist on the screen right now, and I hope to catch you in the next one.